the snow.
Is that error free enough? Oh, we're already underway.
Marco Odermatt, leader after the first run, going for what would be a ninth consecutive giant slalom win. He's won every single giant slalom since Kranz Gagora last year. His advantage at the top over our current leader, Alexander Steen Olsen, was 0.35 of a second.
Oh, he's pushing. He is really pushing. This man wants to keep that unbeaten record so far this season. Still hangs on to 3/10. That's only 0.05 of a second less than he started. The second run. Oh, I thought the ski had come off there. Somehow he's managing to keep the skis pointing down the hill, but he's getting chattered around by this second run.
Well, we saw him make huge mistakes in Val d'Isère. We saw him make huge mistakes in Schladming. But he's made a huge mistake here in Bansko. It doesn't seem to make any difference. He's still absolutely flying down here, Odermatt. He's motoring. This, I don't think, is going to be close at all unless there is another massive error from the Swiss maestro as he goes for 9 in a row. The first female skier to win 9 in a row in a specific discipline since Tomba. And oh my God, he's done it by 9/10 of a second. What can you say? Every time we watch this man race, we say you run out of superlatives. Just wow, it's incredible.
Unbelievable, unbelievable stuff. You know, up at the top was aggressive and really was pushing hard. And then he just cut, you know, he made those errors and he understands that he's made the errors. And then he just switches gears, goes, right, I know I've made mistakes and I've got to push, I've got to take the risk. And Marco Odermatt, unbelievable closing turns there. Lovely and smooth, aggressive. He was tall, he was above the ski. He was ahead of the game through those tough turns towards the finish and continues that unbeaten run so far this season. Unbelievable skiing.
Ed, the winning margin in Val d'Isère, 0.98. The second Alta Badia one was 1.05. 1.26 in Adelboden, nearly a second here.